Good afternoon, viewers, and welcome to the much anticipated venue, the Mahaika, over here in Point Fortin. What a lovely Saturday afternoon. Make the starting lineup here. We are still awaiting, and that's the kickoff. And so, what to you, Aaron?
Well, as we saw in the game against Northeast Stars, Bevon Bass and Sylvester Teasdale upon coming onto the field, ignited some fire in the Point Fortin Civic FC boys. So, as a result, I see that they are both in the starting lineups, only two replacements being made, Bass and Teasdale in from the last game. Of course, W Connection not too long off playing in their CONCACAF matchup where they lost 2-0. Usual, as you see, Tuesday get in the way of that one, looking off it to Marcus Joseph. There's Marcus going after that one. He has one on him. That's Williams. Marcus is still there on the far side. That was as much as the coaches would have hoped, but Northeast Stars still played a very good game. I see that the change is being made. Pacheco still in the starting lineup. Marcus is on the far side. He's controlling, he's deciding he's going to Jadao. So that's
no piece of football there, and good again, good defending there. So far, what we have been seeing with the Point team is good defending, you know, from in all the games so far.
Good job of leading his team thus far this season for their two victories. Second victory, one of the most memorable of any of these players' career, I'm quite sure. Tuesday there. This could be interesting. And Marcus Joseph not being able to get that one down.
It was a good idea.
Some of the big buddies, Wesley John inside there, Helican for by Teasdale. Teasdale not being able to get it down. The supporters even behind the goal there, getting into the action, trying to control everyone easily. We see him actually. Nice little in football there by Andre Tuesdale, looking for Marcus Joseph. Pass probably was a bit too early, but where's Marcus? He has it on, has one man on him, taking a shot. Just going past the outstretched arm there of goalkeeper Archibald. But I think Archibald had that one covered on the ground, George. He read the angle well, and Marcus Joseph and another shot. So as I said a couple of minutes ago, here's Morris. He's looking inside. And it's going to be just too strong for Marcus Joseph. I question if Marcus just pulled the dive out. If he threw on his Superman cape and pulled the dive out on that one, if he'd have been able to get to it. Can't quite tell. Morris looking inside. Headed strongly there for a tribute of Diaz, but not to be, as it goes out of touch. Has one on him. That's Frederick Teasdale. He's here in the chance. Shaking a shot there and straight into the arms of Archibald. Marcus Joseph was wide open. He was really begging, pleading for that one. Williams looking upfield. That's a strong collision there. Three players colliding, and I think, awkwardly enough, both players getting hit in their mid region. You don't see that very often. And we see a yellow card going up just as quickly being infringed there as Jared Williams, the vice captain of W Connection. So there, but coming into his aid, coming to his help.
And we see, I think this is actually the first time in the last two games I've seen that misunderstanding in the defense of the Point team.
If you had the ways, Marcus Joseph loves to go left. If you're a defender and you've studied Marcus Joseph, you'd know that the left-footed player loves to go left, and the referee blows his whistle to signal the end of the first half. So, George, at the end of the first half, W Connection 0, Civic FC 0.
Well,
yeah, the whistle for the start of the second half.
Well, it's going to be very interesting to see the second half of this encounter, because I am doubting that both teams will want to leave it down to the penalty spot. So it's going to be interesting. It's going to be an exciting next 45 minutes, and already we are here in the rhythm section striking up. So maybe this is what the Point team needs right now, an early strike from the rhythm section.
Quite going to be taking a shot here as he sends this one inside. It's too low. Control there by the handle.
That
referee wasn't.
The referee actually was behind the player, so he didn't really see.
Frederick there getting away with murder because he was just on the edge, as we see a nice corner attacking opportunity here. Here's Jordan. Shot coming in wide. It's going to be deflecting out of touch for a corner kick. Wrong to think that Point doesn't deserve a spot in the Pro League, as we see Connection trying to make something happen in the Point half of the field. Shot coming in. This could be a very good save by Mark.
Very good save there coming in from
That was a shot from Jared Williams, but it's not over yet. It's going out of touch. Marvin Phillip. That was a shot coming in there from Jared Williams. It fell nicely onto his boot. Bench for Civic FC clearing. So I don't think the coaches are very happy with what's going on. Pacheco with this free kick. Second inside. Heading it down is, and this is an opportunity. Oh, for the ball from Andre Tuesday. George, did you hear that?
That was a roar that we have not heard in football for so while, but a good opportunity again there coming from Andre Tuesday.
Here's Diaz. What will Diaz do? He gets it to Marcus Joseph. Loving that left side is Marcus Joseph. What will he do? Try to get past Joe Dow. Does so. Shot come in. Oh! Just on the side, nothing there. Marcus Joseph. He saw the same thing in the last game, taking a shot on the very on the left side and hitting the side netting.
I have with me here the CEO of the Pro League, Dexter Scheme. Dexter, I think this is one of the things that we have been asking for a long time, to bring football back into the communities. We are here this afternoon. What's your thought on this evening's proceedings?
I think this is the step in the right direction. It's the watershed in Pro League history now today. I have been advocating this as well, but this is an idea whose time has come. There are those who would say we maybe are not ready yet, but I think the definition of insanity is continuing to do the same thing and expect different results. We have to do this. I think the model is all over the world about setting up your business, your brand in a community where there is a market, and from there then you can generate the brand awareness, loyalty, the brand strengths and so on, and your vision and your mission, and then from there you then are in a position from your market to then generate the sales and your revenues and so on to expand your business and to ensure that your business survives. And this is the model. This is no different in football. So this is where we have to go. I personally, I'm going to ensure that we continue to do this. I'm looking at other venues as well. Woodford Lodge in Central.
That's
as
good
well
idea.
As in Arima, the Velodrome as well. Mm-hmm. So it's no turning back now. That's my stand on it, and I'm going to take this fully and take it by the scruff of the neck and continue to develop this model, because this is success. This is where it is. This is what the people are calling for. And
it's a long time they've been calling for this.
That's right. And football is the people's business. And who am I to say, or the board to say, that we are not going to, we want to play in the stadium? No, I mean, if you have to take a little inconvenience within the meantime, within sometimes, you know, that's sometimes you have to sacrifice for growth, you know.
Some 15 minutes left in this one in regulations. Still 0-0 here at the Mica Oval in Point Fortin. Ball looking inside for Andre Tuesday. This combination is a shotgun from Tuesday. Wide left footed shot there. Funny enough, Giorgio, I just saw a supporter fall to the ground on that one. Supporters actually on the roof of their houses, and that's no short fall, George. As you can see, that's a two-story building, and supporters actually on the roof of their houses. So you can see what football in Point Fortin is doing, George. I am not going that high on my roof to look at any football. I'm sorry. I'd rather pay my $20 and come in. Hitting my close one in the back of the net. Joseph takes it and it's into the arms, almost out, but eventually holding on to it quite nicely is Archibald. So Pacheco not taking that one there. Marcus Joseph did able to get past him. Very quick with the ball at his feet is Marcus Joseph. Very skilled as well. And we see the load of share actually coming on that very skillful football there by Marcus Joseph.
I think some of the players on the playing team got taken up in that play from Marcus. I didn't realize that opportunity was coming there for them.
Referee looking at his watch.
I don't think there's much time. I think that we're going to hear that whistle anytime, and it's going to straight to the penalty spot.
And that's it. Matthew Bartholomew versus Archibald. Here's Bartholomew. Goal.
And it's goal number one. And you can hear the supporters.
We're just... Here's Span. Goal! No, actually, it's off the upright. I thought I saw Marvin going the wrong way, and I thought it would have been in, but Silvio Span hitting it off the upright. Marcus. Goal! Civic FC 2-0. standing over this one is Mikel Williams, doing a very good job of defending for his team all game. He's now asked to score against Marvin Phillip. It's getting darker here in Civic in point. Here's Williams. Tickling to the spot. Shot save on the back of the net. Very good guess by Marvin Phillip, but a better shot there from Mikel Williams. I thought it was saved initially, not to be, piling it into the back of the net. It's on the penalty spot, getting it off the upright. Here's Pacheco. Guessing the right way, but it's getting it in the back of the net. Not being able to get there. Good goalkeeping, but not long enough. Really upset with himself as Archibald. He really guessed the right way, but just getting his fingertips on tip. Had a tough game. Defended well by Wesley John and Diaz. Will he be able to put it past Marvin Phillip here now? Shot testing in the right direction, but lodged in the back of the net. Back of the net for Jamal Clarence. Saved! Very good save by Archibald. Guessing in the right direction. Not being able to get it past him is Diaz. And it's 3-2, four opportunities for Civic. They have scored three goals, three opportunities so far. Walking to the spot to get the fourth is Frederick. Marvin Phillip.
We'll have to,
if he saves this one, George, he can hear an uproar.
What an awful taking penalty. I think he has to stay on the ground.
Archibald with a very good save last time around. Let's see what he can do now. Here's Teasdale. Archibald. Teasdale off the upright. And not quite yet, ladies and gentlemen. Some poor free kick for poor penalties. In the back of the net. Penalties. Even. Here's Etienne, another defender, 4.4 in Civic FC. Can he score here? Yes, he does. Yes. Marvin Phillip is yet to pull off a save. Tremaine Paul has an opportunity to push it even further. Here it goes. Marvin Phillip guessing the wrong way. Goal for Tremaine Paul. Captain Modest is going to be walking to the spot. Those who are sitting would be at the end of their seats. Nails are being bitten. And here's Modest taking a shot. Goal! Captain scoring. Guessing the wrong way, but no matter if he guessed the right way, that was so well taken by Modest. No possible.
And it's a long one.
Goal! Yes. Up where you would call that the jetness.
Up in the V.
Up in the V. Another left footed kicker here for Civic FC. Shot coming in. George, I can't say I'm surprised. So do or die. It's due for Neil Benjamin. Goal! W Connection move on to the semifinals.
Has gone silent. The crowd has gone silent, Aaron. And I think we lost the match. I think we lost the match on that penalty kick by Teasdale. But nevertheless, a good showing by the point team, and there's nothing to be